Welcome to My Tech Gear, and welcome to another Tech Tip Tuesday. Today, I'll be taking you through a step-by-step guide on how to get your Oculus Quest 1 or 2 set up to run PC-based VR games, and in the process, introduce you to a whole new world of high-fidelity virtual reality. I'll be going through three easy steps to set up your Quest to work with the Oculus Rift Store so you can play PC VR Rift games on your Quest. And I'll be taking you through the three additional steps needed to get your Quest running VR games from the Steam gaming platform. This introduces you to a whole other platform of high quality VR games such as Medal of Honor and Half-Life Alyx, and I thoroughly recommend getting this set up. So let's jump straight into it. So before we go any further, if you do enjoy the video, please don't forget to like and share it. And if you're not subscribed yet, then hit that subscribe button down below and that notification bell so you're notified about new videos as and when I post them. It really helps me grow this channel so that I can keep making videos like this for you. Thanks. So why should you do this when the Quest is a standalone VR headset already? Well, as great as the Quest is, experiencing VR from a PC will introduce you to a far higher fidelity of games. This will allow you to also access games from the Steam platform, so you'll have a wider range of games to play, and so you also aren't held captive by Oculus as the only platform from which you can buy games. And setup itself is actually pretty easy and takes just three main steps. Get a PC, get a USB cable, install some software. That's it. So the first issue we need to address is this, the PC. As the PC will now be running the VR games rather than your headset is basically now just a display, you're going to need a PC capable of running VR games. Oculus have released what it regards as the minimum spec for this, which is over here. Now, I did go into this in a little bit of detail in my most asked questions video, so feel free to pop over to that one and watch that video first if you want. Cards up there if you want to go and watch that, and I'll put a link in the description down below. Long story short, you'll need a PC with at least 8GB of RAM, Windows 10, and an Intel i5 or a Ryzen 5 CPU or higher. So for graphics cards, if you already have a PC, then you should be fine with an Nvidia 1660 or equivalent or higher. Now, you can go lower according to those specs, but you're really touching the edge of the limits of what a PC can handle. And PC VR games are just going to get more and more intensive as time goes on, so you do want to give yourself some longevity in the card that you own. If you're looking at upgrading your PC or you're looking at buying a PC now, then certainly I'd recommend any PC based on the new Nvidia 30 series graphics cards. I recently bought an MSI Ventus 2X 3060 Ti graphics card for my PC, which is behind me, and I've been super impressed with its performance for VR. For around $400, it's a great card. If you'd like to see the review for that, then I'll put the link up above there once I've done it, and also in the description down below. So in order to attach the Quest to the PC, you will need a USB-C cable to connect the two. Now you can use the cable that came with the Quest, assuming your PC has a USB-C port, but it's not really long enough, and certainly the Quest 2 only came with a 1 meter cable, and that's way too short. Now you could use them just for setting up though, but please don't play a game with them because you're gonna break something. Now, my recommendation is to get a 5 meter USB-C cable. You could get a 3 meter one, but I find that anything shorter than 5 meters and your movement will be limited due to the cable length. This matches the spec of the official Oculus Link cable, which is also 5 meters. The official cable will set you back a cool $75 though, so it's certainly not cheap. However, it will give you one of the most reliable cables to use. There are alternatives in the market though that you can get for roughly half this price. Whilst technically any USB cable that matches the USB 2.0 spec should work, I would recommend getting one that matches 3.1 spec or higher, as you want data and power to go through the cable and also give you the highest chance of being able to handle some of the high graphical data games that you're going to be playing. Make sure you get the right connectors for both the Quest and your PC. So you'll need a cable with a USB-C plug on one end to plug into your Quest, and either a USB-C or a USB-A plug to plug into your PC, depending upon which port you've got available. Again, aim for USB 3.0 or higher ports where you can. They're typically colored blue on the inside of the socket on a PC to help you easily identify them. You can also get USB-C to USB-A adapters if you need to convert existing cables you might have. I'll place some links to alternative cables you can purchase in the description down below, which are roughly half the price of the Oculus cable if you want to go down that route. So once we've got the cable set up and we've got the PC, we're now into software. Now, the official Oculus Quest app needs to be installed on your PC in order for the VR games to run on your PC and show up on your Quest. So you need to go to oculus.com/setup and download the Oculus Link software. This is what allows you to play the PC VR games on your headset. Once it's downloaded, double click on the file and follow the instructions to install the app. The first time you run it, it will take you through a first time setup process, and it's pretty simple to follow. Once the app is open, select Add New Headset and select either the original Oculus Quest or Oculus Quest 2, depending on which one you have. You'll be taken through a simple setup process. Once that's all set up, you can now download and play your first PC VR game. Inside the Quest itself, when it's connected, you'll notice that your lobby changes. It's not the typical Quest home screen. So you're now in the Oculus PC VR lobby, and so the menus will start to look a little bit different, which is the indication that you're all set up and you're actually in PC VR. Buying games and running them is now exactly the same as if you were buying any normal game in the Quest store. The only difference now is that you are buying games that are PC-based VR games. Be careful here, as any game you buy will only run from the PC. So don't go and buy Beat Saber on the PC and expect to be able to play it standalone on the Quest, because it won't work. For Beat Saber, you will need to buy it twice. There are some games, however, that are cross-buy. So if you buy them on one platform, you'll get it for free on the other. However, that list is somewhat limited. I'll put a link in the description down below that will take you to that list. So that's it. That's all the steps you need to get Oculus PC VR games working with your Quest headset. If, however, you want access to even more games, then Steam is the place to be. Steam is another PC game store that has a far wider selection of VR games, and fortunately these games are also playable using the Quest. So if you want to look into the Steam VR store as well, then there's just three simple, easy to follow steps needed for that, which are installing the Steam app on the PC, installing Steam VR on the PC, and then running Steam VR from the Quest headset. So let's go through each of those. So the first thing we need to do is install the Steam Store app. So go to their website, which is store.steampower.com, download the app, and then install it. If you don't already have a Steam account, then you will need to set one up when you first install the app. Once it's installed and your account is set up, then the first step is to check whether your PC is VR ready. So run the Steam app that you just installed and search for Steam VR. In the search results, there will be a Steam VR performance test app. Now you want to run that, and that will run a sequence of tests on your PC to ensure that it's good enough to run your PC VR games. The summary screen that comes up will let you know whether your system is good to go or whether there are any components like your CPU or your graphics card that might need upgrading. Assuming it's all green, then once it's complete, then search for Steam VR again in the Steam store, and there is a Steam VR app and you want to install that. Once that's done, you're all ready for it to run on your Quest headset. So now we just need to run Steam VR from your Oculus Quest headset. So with the Oculus Link app running on your PC and your Quest already connected to the PC with the cable that we've got, and yourself in that PC VR home screen on your Quest headset, you need to select Virtual Desktop from the menu bar on the bottom. When you go into that, you should find a Steam VR shortcut on your desktop. That shortcut should have been installed when you installed the Steam VR game on your PC previously. So you just need to hold down your trigger button when you're pointing at that for about a second or two. When you release the trigger, the pop-up menu, select Open. It will now run Steam VR, and that's it. Once it loads, which can take a while, you will be in a different home screen, which is the Steam home screen. This will display any games that you have purchased on the Steam store in your Quest headset. Select the one you want to play, and away you go. So if this is the first time you've run this, chances are you're looking at a blank screen because you haven't bought any apps yet. So go back to the Steam Store app that you installed on your PC, find a game that you want, buy it, download it, and then the next time you go back to your Quest, it will be there in your Steam home screen. Now you may get a message pop up in your Quest headset that says you can't run the app from unknown sources. Now the Steam VR app is considered by Oculus to be an unknown source. So in order to fix that, you need to go into the Oculus app on your PC and enable unknown sources. The app will then run Steam VR without issue. So now that you've run Steam VR once, it will now appear in your apps drawer in the Oculus home screen. So it will be easy to launch going forwards the second, third, fourth time because you won't need to keep going into virtual desktop to run it. One of the things that will surprise you will be the size of games. If you're used to maybe 2-3 gig size of files on Quest games, this is going to blow you out of the water. PC VR games can be big, so make sure you've got plenty of storage on your PC. Asgard's Wrath, for instance, is 135 gig. That's for one game, so get ready for a pretty big hard drive that's going to have to sit in your PC. Two of the biggest issues that are likely to be your stumbling block here for a smooth graphical experience is going to be a good graphics card and the USB cable. For the graphics cards, try to get the best one that you can. And if you're still finding yourself stuttering issues, then start playing around with the graphics settings in each game to see if that improves it. The other issue can be around USB cables. So whilst the recommendation has been to get USB 3.1 Gen 2 cables, I've actually been able to run Half-Life Alyx at ultra graphical settings using a USB cable and USB extender, which I just had lying around the house. No specific cable was needed. The Oculus app did issue a warning stating that it wasn't a USB 3 cable, but it still worked fine without any issues. No stutter or no drop frames either, that I noticed. Certainly when Oculus Link first came out, it was super ropey and required certain USB cables, but it's matured a lot over the last year, and now games run on far more cables than they ever did. So I'd actually recommend just trying it out with whatever cables you happen to have lying around the house. You might be surprised with what works. The USB extender that I got only cost me a few dollars, so it could be a really cheap way to get that cable length that you need. It won't be able to provide data and power to your Quest though whilst you play, and it will be limited to a 72Hz display rate. So it's a really cheap way to get up and running, and so you don't need to go and get that ultimate cable straight away. I'll place some links on where you can get these cables in the description down below. A great way to test your USB cables actually is using the Oculus Link app on the PC. So with your Quest on and linked to your PC and the app running, in the app, go into devices and you'll see your device. Next to that device will be either a green tick or an orange exclamation mark. Now that tells you whether it's a USB 3 connection, which would be a green tick, or an orange exclamation mark if it's not. So what you can do is if you just unplug the cable that's there and try another cable, the app will automatically test the next cable and either give you a green tick or an orange exclamation mark. So it's a really quick way of trying different cables out and different ports on your PC and quickly seeing what works and what cables are better than others. It is also worth checking the display rate in the Oculus app. By default, it will be set to 72Hz or 72 frames per second that your Quest screen is updating at, even if you've got a USB 3 cable, because Oculus recommends 72Hz as the default. If you've got a USB 3 cable though, so that green tick I was talking about, you can increase it to 90Hz. Now, I've tried both and the playability of both has been fine. The latter is slightly smoother and you'll have varying levels of success depending on each game as well. If you want to increase it to 90Hz in that display settings, you should have a selection option and you can choose 72, 80 or 90Hz, but again, only with a USB 3 cable. So that's it. You should now be all set up and ready to play your PC-based VR games using your Quest headset on either the Oculus or the Steam platforms. I hope this guide was helpful. Do let me know in the comments down below how you got on. Do you think the PCR is worth it, or you're quite happy just playing on the Quest stand alone? Are there killer games you think everyone should be playing on PC VR? Do hope you enjoy the PC VR games, and as always, see you in the next one.